Hey guys, Luke here. Another week of football, another week of tipping. Let's get into it. I've got to say, going through all the games, there's actually quite a number of games that do look pretty juicy. Roosters and Broncos should be a great game, two strong teams. We've also got the Panthers taking on the Tigers, a newfound rivalry. We have Parramatta versus Sharks, two pretty even teams, two teams going pretty well this year. We also have a clash of potentially the best team in the comp up against the worst team in the comp in Melbourne versus the Bulldogs. Just before we get into my tips though, make sure you go ahead and leave a like on the video and subscribe to the channel if you're new around here. So on Thursday night, we have the Sydney Roosters taking on the Brisbane Broncos. Like I said earlier, I think this is going to be a great game. Now, I've got to say, both teams haven't been that impressive to start off the season. The Broncos, I think, have had a better victory overall. But, I mean, the Roosters, they've won a few games, but they haven't done it very convincingly. Apart from the Rabbitohs game, which they were easily outclassed, they have been winning, but they've been sort of all over the place. They haven't been able to play Kronk or Frank consistently, and they've been moving Latrell Mitchell around and a whole bunch of other players around, and I don't know, it's been a bit of a shit fight for the Roosters. But still, they've been getting the job done, and apart from the Rabbitohs game, there's never really been a time where you thought, yeah, they're probably going to lose this game. The Broncos, on the other hand, apart from the destruction of the Cowboys, they have been very, very disappointing. Going into the season, I wasn't expecting big things from the Broncos, but I thought they'd definitely be better off at this point in the season. The halves are, there's a lot of question marks over the halves, let's just say that. James Roberts is missing this week, an Achilles injury. He actually has been quite good despite his injury. Jack Bird in the other center position has been very, very good. There's a lot of players who have been quite good for him, but they just haven't been able to put it together week after week, and that's going to be a big thing for the Broncos. However, when they take on teams like the Roosters, those big teams, they do seem to step it up. And I wouldn't be surprised if the Broncos came out and won this game, especially with how the Roosters have been going. No Jake Friend for the Roosters, he is a big loss. Victor Radley in the at hooker. But overall, I still think the Roosters will have a good enough team to beat the Broncos side. I do think it will be close, but I do think the Roosters will win 1-12. On to the first game of Friday, we have the New Zealand Warriors taking on the Gold Coast Titans. I'm going to be honest, I don't really know what to say about this game. I'd say both sides have been quite disappointing to start the season, but both have had their reasons. The Warriors, they're trying to find, you know, what they want to do with life after Sean Johnson. They've replaced Kieran this week. They've brought in Chanel Harris-Tavita, I believe that's how you say it. But the Titans, they haven't even played a game with their proper halves pairing. They've been having makeshift halves. You know, Riley Jack's been there a little bit, Chiron Peachy a little bit, even AJ Brimson. But they haven't had Ash Taylor for any of their games this year. So it's hard to get a reading on the Titans. They haven't been good, but they have had their reasons for not being good. The Warriors, on the other hand, you know, they were good the first week. But apart from that, they haven't really shown too much. Now, the Titans haven't won a game all year, and for that reason, I think they'll just go into it a little bit more hungry. Ash Taylor with a point to prove, and also Tyron Roberts for that matter as well. And for that reason, I'm going to go the Gold Coast Titans 1-12. On to the second game of Friday night, we have the Penrith Panthers taking on the West Tigers. Now, straight up, the Tigers, they were trash last week. They were so bad. Moses Umbai, I swear, he was still playing for the Bulldogs. The amount of errors he made, it was just way too much. But I wouldn't expect him to do it this week. Moses Umbai is a pretty decent player. He's not like a superstar. He's not a world beater, but he is a pretty good player. He's the captain of the Tigers side, and I do think he'll be a lot better this week. The Panthers have also dropped their fullback. Dylan Edwards was gone. He was their worst player by far last week, and I think they'll be much better off with Watene Zalesniak at fullback, even though he hasn't been incredible, but I think he's more consistent, he's more experienced. I think they're just better off with him at fullback. But the Panthers, they really need to step it up. I know it's only early on in the season, but they need to find something. I don't even know what is their best side. I don't even know where their strike power is going to come from. I know Wonga Blake's pretty good, but apart from that, like, Mansell hasn't really done too much. They do have the ability to do it. It's just a matter of finding consistency, and the Panthers haven't done it so far. Same can be said about the Tigers, though. The Tigers, very good at stages. They won the first 2 weeks, but then last week, losing to the Bulldogs, that is just unacceptable. I'm a Bulldogs fan, and you should not be losing to the Bulldogs. For the Tigers, though, Josh Reynolds comes into the halves, and I think that will be a good boost. He's got a lot of energy, Josh Reynolds, and although Benji is very, very good, I don't know if they necessarily need him. Luke Brooks can steer the ship around. Robbie Farah's been doing a good job. I think Josh Reynolds will add a lot to this side. However, I don't think it will be enough to get the win. I think the Penrith Panthers will win this 1-12. On a super sad day, we had the Manly Warringah Sea Eagles taking on the South Sydney Rabbitohs. Well, I certainly didn't expect to be going into this game saying Manly looked the better out of the teams last week. Rabbitohs, they got the job done, but it was only against the Titans. And the Titans, I've just talked about them earlier, they're not very good, and they didn't even have their main halves. Manly, on the other hand, absolutely destroyed the Warriors. I didn't expect that to happen. Tom Trbojevic, though, he's come back into the side. We all know he's a great player. I didn't know he had that much of an impact on the side. I knew he was going to be good for him, but yeah, that was just, he was just next level last week. Coming straight back in off a hamstring injury. A lot of players struggle with hamstring injuries, but Tommy Turbo seemed to handle it fine. He stepped in, and that was just a whole different team. Now, I think this game is going to be interesting because I think it's going to be a battle of the forwards. I think Manly, they have a pretty good starting forward pack. Like, they can match it with the Rabbitohs for a little bit, but I think once the game goes on, I think the Rabbitohs will run away with it. But I also do think this game will be won in the backs. Now, the Rabbitohs, Braden Burns is out. They're saying Greg Inglis is probably going to miss the game as well. But overall, I do think they have a much better back line. The Manly side, I mean, Sewell's out. They've dropped a few players, like Brendan Elliott's in the centres. I think that's all that needs to be said. Rabbitohs, 13+. On to game two of Saturday, we have the North Queensland Cowboys taking on the Canberra Raiders. Both of these sides go into the game with one win each. The Cowboys haven't won in a few weeks. They obviously got the win over the Dragons in round one, but apart from that, they have not looked very good. The Raiders, on the other hand, got the win last week. They have looked good at times as well, and I still think they're trying to find the combinations. Nicole Klodstad, he looks very, very good at fullback. Josh Holton looked good. The team, they just look so much better with Aiden Caesar out of the side. I don't know if that's a credit to Sam Williams or the fact that Aiden Caesar just isn't very good, but they look so much better with Sam Williams in the side, and I think they'll win more games with Sam Williams in the side, and they should go forward with him as your halfback. Their forward pack, I love the Englishmen in their side. They're going great. They are really, really good. That's all I can say about them. The Cowboys, on the other hand, they've been kind of underwhelming in their forward pack. They've got a lot of big names. On paper, their forward pack is very, very good, but they've yet to really produce the goods so far. So it'll be a good test for them because the Raiders side actually has a pretty good forward pack despite losing some of their players that they've lost. Like, you'd think losing players like Junior Paulo and Shannon Boyd would really sort of reduce their forward pack, but I think it's actually strengthened. They've brought in these English guys, and I think they've got a much better overall forward pack. But yeah, the Cowboys, they really need to step it up, and I do think they will do that this week. I think the Cowboys, in front of their home side, they've been a bit disappointed in the last few weeks. I think they'll step it up, and I do think they'll get the job done. However, I don't think it'll be an easy one. I think the Raiders put up a big fight, but I do think the Cowboys will win this 1-12. On to the final game of Super Saturday, where the Parramatta Eels taking on the Cronulla Sharks. I'm just going to say it, I think this game has the potential to be match of the round. I think between this and the very first game, the Roosters and the Broncos, I think either one of them is going to be match of the round. Parramatta have been playing quite well, although they didn't get the job done last week against the Roosters. At times, you thought they might have got the job done. Roosters obviously ran away with it in the end, but the Eels did look quite good. On the other hand, we had the Sharks, who had a very, very good performance against the Cowboys, but I just got done talking about the Cowboys. Cowboys have been so hot and cold. They haven't really been that good this year. Now, the Sharks have been missing Matt Moylan. I think Paul Gallen as well is missing, but Matt Moylan for sure is gone. So Josh Duggar moves to fullback. Bronson Zeri makes his debut in the centres, and there's big reps in this kid. I've seen Clarkus Colum talk about him a lot. I've seen a lot of people talk about him. They've said once he gets in the side, good luck to whoever he replaces. And Josh Duggan is that man. Well, kind of Matt Moylan is, but I don't know. He's taken Dugan's spot. I think Bronson Zeri will have a very, very good game. Overall, I do think both teams are quite solid. I think Dylan Brown will actually be a huge loss. For a rookie, he's been outstanding. The ability for him to just take on the line. A lot of the times of rookie halves, they sort of just let the other half take the reins. And although he has been doing that, he also hasn't been afraid of taking the line on. We've seen him be a very, very good attacker. His defense has also surprisingly been quite good. So we'll have to wait and see how this Semen guy goes, because I don't really know much about him apart from he got in trouble before the season started and pretty much guaranteed Brown's spot. But hey, it's his opportunity. Will he tackle with two hands? It remains to be seen. The Sharks, I do think they're finally starting to gel, in particular with their halves. Now, Johnson and Townsend obviously have played together before, but it's been a few years. Add in the Brayley brothers rotating, and I know Matt Moylan's out this week. He was starting to look pretty good at fullback there, but Josh Duggan is a former New South Wales fullback as well, so he's no slouch. Him going back there, it shouldn't be that big of a deal for the Sharks, and for that reason, I do think the Sharks are going to win this 1-12. On to Sunday, we have the Melbourne Storm taking on Mike Andrew Bankstown Bulldogs. It feels like every week the Bulldogs are playing in the same time slot, Sunday afternoon football, but I'm not complaining. I don't mind it. The Bulldogs last week were absolutely outstanding, completely flogged the Tigers from start to finish. Tigers never really in the game. We just dominated them, and I'm not even exaggerating there. The Bulldogs were very, very good. Kieran Foran started though. He's not going to be there this week. Injured himself, scoring a try. Did play the rest of the game, but he's going to be out for months, so that's a big loss. Jack Cocker comes in, has obviously played first grade before, played a little bit with the Newcastle Knights. He's looked okay in reserve grade, but We've got him and Lewis in the halves, and I don't know, Lewis can get the job done. We saw him get the job done with Frawley last year, and Frawley was awful, but Cogger, Lewis, we'll see how they go. And taking on Melbourne, who are arguably the best team in the comp, in fact, I'm going to say they are the best team in the comp at this point, it's going to be a big ask for the young halves, but I don't know, I think they could have a decent game, but I don't think it really matters. I think the Storm are just way too good. Even if the halves play decent for the Bulldogs, I think the Storm are still going to win this very, very comfortably. They've just been way too good this half the season. Just the Storm, I don't know, they're just a Storm. They're the Storm of old. Doesn't matter if you get rid of Kronk or Slater, they're still going to be right up there, as long as they have Cameron Smith anyways. So overall, I do think the Bulldogs put up a bit of a fight. I think they'll stay with the Storm for a little bit, but I think at the end of the day, the Storm will run away with it, and I think they'll win 13+. On to the last game of the round, we have the Newcastle Knights taking on the St. George Illawarra Dragons. This is another game that I think could be really good. The Newcastle Knights have the potential to explode and be this great attacking side, and I think they're more likely to do that now that Ponga's moved to fullback. I think Connor Watson is in the halves, or Leno, someone's in the halves. The Dragons, on the other hand, got the job done last week. They actually looked very, very good. Finally, it looked like they had settled their spine issues, and then Gareth Widdop does his shoulder and is out for the season pretty much. So, I don't know, I think it's going to be, he's going to be a huge loss. Like, there's no doubt about it. Gareth Widdop is, in my opinion, their best player at this point, but there is talks that Frizzell might play. I think he'd be a big in. Obviously hurt his balls, which is, I wouldn't wish that upon anybody, so I'm not sure if that's something you want to rush back from. But I mean, taking on the Knights, I think they do have the potential to beat the Knights for sure. However, I do think the Knights, in front of their home crowd, also with their form the last few weeks, they haven't really, I don't know, they just haven't really been that good, the Knights, but they still haven't been that far off, if that makes sense. They certainly show little glimpses of being good, and, you know, maybe this is the game where they're going to put it all together. For that reason, I do think the Knights have that just little bit extra class now that Widdop's not playing, and I do think the Knights win 1-12. So guys, those are my tips. So far, I haven't been doing too bad with my tips, but I'm a little bit worried about this week. A few games, I wasn't really sure. Leave in the comment section below, who are your tips for this week? Righto guys, that is the end of the video. Hopefully you did enjoy. If you did, make sure you go ahead and smash the like button and subscribe to the channel if you're new around here. Also, make sure to follow me on Twitter and Instagram. It's on the screen right now. Also, go ahead and give me a like on Facebook. I've been posting a lot more on there. Been trying to get into the Facebook pages like Clarkie's Column and NRL My Opinion and all that sort of stuff. So yeah, definitely give me a like on that. Also, add me on Snapchat, Mr. Luke on YT. I sort of post little things of me watching the games and just general bullshit, to be honest. But yeah, that's the end of the video. Thank you for watching, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.